noisy. Our commentary team, Adam Smith, joined by Spencer Oliver in Liverpool, and our master of ceremonies, all set, John MacDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's our main event. Please welcome to the ring now, from Manchester, Jamie Moore.
Golden opportunity for the young, talented and hungry Salford Southport, Jamie Moore. We were expecting the ring walk of Newport's temperamental banger Paul Samuels, but last weekend he pulled out with a virus. Monday lunchtime, Moore's mobile rang, offering him the chance to fight for the British and Commonwealth light middleweight titles, and his answer, immediate. Let's get it on. Betting underdog, less pressure, Spencer, little to lose.
Well, this is a massive chance for Jamie Moore, coming at short notice, but must fancy the job, otherwise he wouldn't have taken it. He's not a journeyman, 16 wins out of the 17 contests, so he wouldn't have taken it if he wasn't totally confident in his ability to win.
Looks very calm and composed, and has brought a few fans here too. Fancies his chances.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the ring the current Commonwealth champion from Liverpool, Destiny Michael Joe.
What an atmosphere. Loyal fans, will we be finally able to answer one of British boxing's lingering questions this year? How good is Liverpool's long and rangy light middleweight, Michael Joe? An outstanding amateur. He's never been beaten as a professional, but his career has been plagued by injuries, inactivity and insufficient exposure. You know him, but those who do say he's such a dedicated individual, and he has the talent to launch him, they believe, into even world-class. Big calls, Spencer, but he's done nothing wrong yet.
Well, I've known Michael for a number of years, right back to his schoolboy days, and he was always a top-class amateur, and he turned out that in the professional ranks, hasn't put a foot wrong so far. Lovely boxer, and this should be a great contest.
He believes this is his year, his time. Let's have a look at the tail of the tape. Jamie Moore, 4 years younger, but look at that height difference between them. Both just inside the 11 stone limit, but Michael Joe's more of a light middleweight. Jamie Moore has sort of been between welter and light middle himself. Jamie Moore debuted just 3 years ago. Jones, a longer career, same amount of fights, more experience for Jones, but the bigger puncher, Jamie Moore. Interesting early.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to Everton Park Leisure Centre for tonight's championship boxing, proudly presented by Barry Hearn for Ringside Boxing Promotions in association with Prince Promotions and Matchroom Sport. All sponsored here by PokerMillion.com for a great game of online poker. Ladies and gentlemen, this is 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant British title and the coveted Commonwealth Light Middleweight Championship. And a very warm welcome to our viewers joining us live and exclusive here on Sky Sports. You've joined us for the very best ringside seat in the business. All the officials have been appointed by the British Boxing Board of Control in association with the Commonwealth Council. Supervisor at ringside, Mr. Dennis Lockton. Steward in charge, His Honour, Alan Simpson. Our inspectors, Steve Ray, Ron Warburton, Jeff Bolter and Kevin Leaf. Our three medical officers, Dr. Stead, Dr. Thomas and Dr. Levan. Our timekeeper at the bell is Mr. Paul Webster. And when the action begins, a referee in charge from Wolverhampton is Mr. John Coyle. They are the officials, here are the contestants, and firstly the challenger. He's fighting out of the red corner. He wears the black trunks trimmed with silver, weighing in 10 stone, 13 pounds, 10 ounces, bringing a 17 fight record, 16 wins, 11 inside the scheduled distance, and just one loss. He's from Manchester. Please welcome Jamie Moore. And now, ladies and gentlemen, comes the champion. He's fighting under the blue corner wearing the white trunks trimmed with gold. Weighing in at 10 stone, 13 pounds, 10 ounces. An undefeated professional record. 17 contests, 17 wins, 7 inside the scheduled distance. He is the reigning and defending Commonwealth champion. Ladies and gentlemen, making his first defense, he's from the beautiful city of Liverpool. It's Destiny, Michael Jules. Let's get the action underway. 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant British title and the coveted Lonsdale belt and the Commonwealth Light Middleweight Championship.
Gentlemen, let me just remind you of those three things. Obey my instructions, obey the rules, and let's see good sportsmanship. Shake hands, goodbye.
Fascinating tactical tussle for the vacant British 11 stone belt and with Michael Jones's Commonwealth title also at stake. The enormous light middleweight once more on home turf. He was expecting another tall boxer with big hooks in Paul Samuels. He's had 5 days to rethink his strategy against this small, strong and muscular southpaw who can rough it up with his quick and clever combinations. This may come down to who can adapt better at this late notice.
We'll expect Jones to box on the outside, pushing out that long jab and putting those combinations together, whereas Jamie Moore's going to look to get inside and work the body of Jones.
Moore must find a way past the 73-inch reach. That extended jab. One other interesting factor to add to the equation, keep your eye on the left elbow of Michael Jones, because it kept him out for 9 months last year, a build-up of calcium. He has been struggling with that for a while, but the operation went well, and he said he's using it better than ever in the gym. Different in the ring.
Yeah, certainly is. You don't know if that's going to play on his mind.
Sharp right hand as Jones attempts to get his skills working. Jamie Moore, who has the edge in power, he stopped 11 of his 16 victims inside the distance, but he's got to get inside.
Yeah, we can see the pattern of the fight already developing, with Jones trying to keep it at long range on the back foot, Jamie Moore trying to get inside to work those hooks.
Jones, who can be a slow starter, when he won the Commonwealth title against Joshua Onyango in this ring, dodgy first 4 or 5 rounds settling down. Can Moore exploit him early? He's breaking down the jab, or at least attempting to. Jamie Moore gets him with one of his own. Jones, of course, who has to jab down tonight with this big height difference. How tricky will that be for him?
Well, this is another factor in this fight. He was training for Paul Samuels, who's another tall light middleweight. All of a sudden, he's got a short, stocky one in front of him, so you don't know how that's going to affect him either. I'm sure Jones has had enough experience through the amateurs and pros to be able to adapt to styles. and a very close first round there.
Michael Jones with the experienced team of Ray Farrell and Morris Corr in there. Was originally with Chris Sanagar, part of the Bristol Boys, but has felt his career has reignited by working with the quiet Mancunian, well respected in these parts.
Some of the good work here from Jones early on, getting through with a jab, but more retaliating with one of his own.
Second round. We're in the 11th stone, 154-pound division. It's the white and gold trunks of Michael Destiny Jones from here in Liverpool, the Speak District that he's trying to fight his way out of. Groomed on the rough streets, as was Jamie Moore, his opponent from Salford in the black. Such a Tyson-esque appearance to him when he turned professional in 1999. Burst on the scene, really, Jamie Moore, with impressive knockouts, quick fire combinations, but has got that one blip on his record, the defeat to Scott Dixon when he ran out of gas. Will stamina come into play? Big point.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the fight, if we go back to the fight, he was really dominating against Dixon. Looked like he was on the verge of winning and just ran out of steam, but was only young. He's still only 24 now. He's probably learnt a lot from that fight, and it's made him a better fighter.
Just trying to get first off with his punches, Jamie Moore. May have the advantage in speed. Remember those raking punches of Jones. Take time to reach. And Moore will try to provide the angles and not give him the room.
He's working well behind the jab in this round, Moore. Beating Jones to the jab. Jones with a good few inches in reach advantage. So he's boxing quite nicely here in the second round.
Setting the pace, Jamie Moore. Is it one he can keep up with? He was due to fight on the bill tonight, but that was in an eight rounder, and this, well, it's for two championships. It's a massive step up. Rhythm at all yet. Moore's making it hard. Battle of the jabs at the moment.
Here, Jones just trying to find his rhythm. Moore doing the right thing, just stalking forward, not allowing Jones to set himself, not allowing Jones to get off with his own jabs. This is good tactics by Jamie Moore early on here.
Good start from the man who's come in at such short notice. Midday Monday, he got the call. Trainer Oliver Harrison, he started with Steve Foster. Oliver's always been in the background with Jamie, and they admitted to me when I came up on Tuesday this week that they hadn't really seen any videos, and they hadn't talked tactics at all. They haven't had much time.
Well, sometimes can be the best way. Here we see some of the good work. Jamie Moore a good few inches shorter, but beating Jones to the jab. He's doing the right thing, Moore, stalking forward, getting off first with the shots. And he's broke Jones's rhythm here.
Gordon, 10 seconds.
Round three. Here's a third round of the 17-0, and a really prestigious amateur as well, who had 91 bouts and won 4 national titles, a string of multi-nations, and boxed some of the best in the world. Moore, a good amateur, told me that he's only ever been destroyed once, and that was by Ricky Hatton, who's here ringside, and they're now best friends. He's doing well here, isn't he?
He is doing well, started this contest very well indeed. He's taking the fight to Jones. Jones can't get into his rhythm. And at the moment, Moore just being first to the punch. Good shot there.
Terrific counter. Down goes Michael Jones, for only the second time in his professional career. Well, well, well. Are we looking at the signs of a big domestic upset here? Michael Jones has a real battle on his hands now. How's he going to cope under the pressure?
Jones needs to get behind the jab, needs to get on his bike. Pushing out threes and fours, keeping it at long range. At the moment, Moore's fighting his fight, getting inside, beating Jones to the punch.
Interesting thing Jones told me this week was that he was scared a little bit of Paul Samuels, but he didn't fear Jamie Moore in any way. I wonder if he might just have underestimated him a touch. What do you think?
Maybe he has, maybe it's a change of styles. Styles make fights. But at the moment, this is where Jones needs to be on the end of the jab. He needs to be keeping it at long range. He's allowing Moore to get inside, and that's Moore's fight. Moore's the short, stocky person. Likes to work the hooks. Jones should be now flicking out that jab, keeping it at range. Champion in there at the moment. He's the one that looks relaxed. Jones looks very uneasy.
Gum shield out. Michael Jones. And there's blood to the face. He's breathing heavily already. He's never really got going, Jones. That jab's got to come into effect, and quickly, you'd have thought.
Well, this is where he should be throwing it now. He should be pumping that jab out, keeping it at range, and then away again, moving. David Moore's a fighter that likes to come forward, plant his feet and bang in the big shots. Jones shouldn't be allowing him to do that. At the moment, Jamie Moore boxing a brilliant fight.
A calm, mature performance from Jamie Moore, who looks so at ease in there as he's breaking down the distance, getting his own combinations off, and giving Michael Jones way to go.
There is, but Moore in total control in there at the moment. Everything Jones is doing isn't working for him. He's falling short, he's looking ragged. Moore's the one that looks nice and comfortable in there.
Again, the blood dribbles from the nose of the 6'1" light middleweight, one of the tallest in the world, Michael Jones. fighter, and the gum shield knocked out again by Jamie Moore. composure, start using the jam in his long right hand, and control the middle of the ring again. More blood from the nose of Michael Jones, which is giving him trouble.
Yeah, you know, we were talking about the gum shield there. I think that's the reason why the gum shield's coming out. Jones can't actually breathe through that nose, and he's just trying to suck air through the mouth. Jamie Moore just beating Jones to the punch at the moment. Jones needs to change tactics, get on the back foot and start trying to work behind the jab, because at the moment he's playing into Jamie Moore's hands.
Fascinating on paper, as intriguing in reality. Good domestic matchup here at the Everton Park Sports Centre in Liverpool.
Pushing Jamie Moore on the back foot. He's tried everything in there so far, Jones. He's tried boxing at long range, he's tried pushing him back. Here we see where the gum shield comes out. Just a little short hook, I think. Jones is struggling to breathe through the nose. So he seems to be gulping up air through the mouth. And that's the reason the gum shield keeps coming out.
Well, so far, so good for the Salford Southpaw in only fight number 18 with his 69-inch reach, 4 inches less than Jones, having all the effect because he's getting inside. This is the round in which Michael Jones started very fast against Joshua Onyango, caught him with a left hook and stopped him after 5-4 rounds to win the Commonwealth Belt last year. But are there signs of panic in this encounter?
Well, there should be, because I've got Jones falling miles behind at the moment. For me, Moore's the one winning every round in there. He's the one getting off first with a punch. Jones needs to take the fight to him, or needs to change the tactics. At the moment, he's just standing there with Moore and allowing Moore to get off with the shots first.
Good defensive work as well from Jamie Moore. Well-schooled himself. And the gum shield again comes loose from Michael Jones. He's gulping for air and having big problems breathing. Body shots come in from Jamie Moore. Beautiful, says Oliver Harrison in the corner. No pressure on him. He is fighting the fight of his life. Can he keep it up?
Well, Jones trying to box to instructions. Got through with a good right hand there. Just seems to stop Moore in his tracks.
Not a big puncher, Michael Jones, but has stopped 7 inside the distance. And he's really trying to wield those hooks in. Moore keeps the elbows tight. He's trying, Michael Jones, so hard.
Yeah, credit to him. He's trying to box the instructions here. His trainer's
fantastic. I would say that's probably the first round I've given Jones. He's really struggling with his southpaw style. Jamie looks really composed, really sharp, and his boxing has to be fantastic.
Richard Williams, the IBO light middleweight champion. It seems like Jamie Moore is actually outboxing the tall boxer.
Absolutely. He's first with the leads. He's hitting him with counter shots. He's boxing beautiful. He looks so composed as well. And Jones at the moment is playing catch up. So,
Ricky, some question marks over Jamie Moore's stamina in a 12-round battle.
Well, that's the thing. He's so far in front, but in a 12-round fight, the fight can change so many times. But this boy from Manchester can fight. Don't you worry about that.
Perfect point there from Ricky Hatton. It can all change so quickly. This is the furthest that Jamie Moore has been in his professional career. But it's Michael Jones that has all the problems so far. Will Moore's stamina last? Will Jones somehow claw his way back and get a foothold in this, what's proving the toughest fight of his life?
Well, Jones really dug deep in that last round to try and turn things around. Let's see if he can sustain that sort of pressure.
Nearly everybody we've spoken to over the last week, including the other light middleweights and the critics and pundits, said that Michael Jones wins middle rounds or on point. I don't think I saw anyone, apart from the Jamie Moore camp, who thought that Moore would win this. Great right hook on the inside, and Michael Jones again in trouble here in the seventh. Gum shield out for the fourth time. He flings his long arms out, almost in desperation, Jones, as Moore keeps the pressure on. He's never taken a backward step, has he?
That's the sheer strength of Moore in there at the moment. Jones just can't keep him up.
Look at the look on Michael Jones's face.
Oh my God.
Moore looks so composed when he's in control. Oh, he walks into a left counter this time from Jamie Moore, who's been very accurate tonight. This is new territory. He did fold against Scott Dixon quite alarmingly. Could it happen again? Doesn't look like it at the moment.
Certainly doesn't. He looks like he's enjoying himself in there at the moment, Adam. He's got a little smile on his face. Jones is the one who looks in desperate trouble. He can't do anything to turn this around. He's trying everything. And now Jamie Moore getting off with good shots again.
Jamie Moore ranked about 8th in the country. Michael Jones arguably 3-4. He's got a win over Takaloo as well early on in his career. What a scalp this would be for Jamie Moore. Oh, uppercuts as well. And he just hasn't been able to get going, Michael Jones, with this nip and tuck, tricky box fighting style. Good left hand, and you felt Jones sag there.
Yeah, it seemed different than these, and just previous to that, Jamie Moore getting off with the jabs every time. Two big shots went in there. The legs of Jones have gone again.
Big shots from Moore going in at the end of the seventh, and is he in the brink of a dramatic victory here? Michael Jones' backyard. Let's listen to Ray Farrell.
You've got to call like this. You've got to call this out.
Right? Yeah. All right.
So good. Okay. Well, listen, Michael, it's going. I'm sure you know that.
Yeah.
You've got to pull something out here.
Well, you've got to show him. This is how he goes.
You've got to show him. You've got to show him that you're the boss. Okay?
You're champion, mate. Come on, you've got to do a show him that you're the champion. Don't get down here for nothing, man. Come on. You got to dig in, Mike.
You got to dig it out now.
Bad as it sounds, you got to do it.
Wonderful corner sound there. Morris Gore with the motivation. Ray Farrell saying you've got to do something. But what, Spencer?
Who knows when he's getting hit with right hands like that? Excellent shot, really. Rocks it down to the soles
on,
of his
Mike,
boots.
Oliver Harrison there saying this has gone absolutely perfectly. Don't mess it up now. Well, listen to the crowd now. Morsi, Morsi. In Liverpool. Will he conquer the local fighter in his backyard at short notice and with all the odds stacked against him? He's been sensible, he's been solid, and he's been efficient, and he's way ahead on your card.
Yeah, that really does reflect the true score there.
Right hand, Gumshield flies out of the ring this time from Michael Jones. And I don't know whether John Coyle noticed that. It's been thrown back into Ray Farrell, but Jones cannot keep that Gumshield in. Precision of Jamie Moore continues to roll. Oh, again, Jones is caught with a left hand. And is it now just a matter of time?
Surely it is. His face is looking a mess in there now. Jones needs to start moving that head. He needs to move the waist. Been hit by the right hand all night, beaten to the jab. And at the moment, definitely looks like he's coming second here.
Notice the gum shield now. Is there any chance, Spencer, he could take a point off because he keeps losing that gum shield?
Do you think that they would take a point off because the gum shield does keep coming out?
Well, Jamie Moore impressed us early on with knockout wins over the likes of Kasikawa, Wayne Shepherd and Richie Murray. But this is a new level, a big leap up in class. And Michael Jones was saying earlier this week he will not know what has hit him, but he's never been allowed to fight his fight, has he?
No, Moore's broke the rhythm from the opening bell. He's the one that's boxed his fight. Superb performance from Jamie Moore.
Into the trenches where Moore hasn't been before and Jones has never been past eight. It's been terrific from the 24-year-old Salford fighter. Inspired by what he saw Ricky Hatton do to Vince Phillips at the MEN Arena a couple of weeks ago. A regular on the boxing circuit, Jamie Moore. Such an affable guy. And I know it will mean the world to him if he can win these titles.
Michael Jones only been hit down once in that third round, but
and Jamie Moore systematically busting Jones up. It's a nice little bit of retaliation there from Jones, but very rare we see it.
And as far as stamina goes, Jamie Moore has answered the question so far. Jones's mouth as Jamie Moore continues to rattle in those body shots, and the left hand, which has hardly missed all night. This terrific former amateur Michael Jones, who had 26 appearances in an England vest. He said he fought all sorts of southpaws and types of opponents, but he obviously never fought anyone quite like Jamie Moore.
Well, Moore doing a real number on him in there. Surely he can't take too much more.
Must be feeling the pace too. You'd have thought Jamie Moore. Can he hold on? He rips in another body shot. Those have been part of his repertoire since the day he turned professional. And on that occasion, he had to pull himself up off the floor at the Bowlers Arena to win against Clive Johnson. That showed he had guts and character. He's proved it coming back from the derailment by Scott Dixon. And it's a total dream for him, and at the moment, a total nightmare for Jones. Have they got anything else to say to him?
Okay, you need two more of them, Michael. Three more of them. All right? Round 10 now. Come on, you got to dig it out.
Yeah.
You got to prove this is where the champions prove themselves.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Three more of them, Ray Farrell saying, suggests that he thought Michael Jones did enough that last round. Would you agree?
What are you going
to
lose?
Well, I think maybe he's just trying to G's fire up, trying to get Jamie Moore to pick it up, Jones to pick it up a little bit more. But really, only see one winner here at the moment. Jamie Moore's beating Jones to the punch, doing everything right.
He's tired.
Farrell at the moment is just trying to gear Jones up.
He's tired, says Oliver Harrison. 9 minutes left of this vacant British light middleweight title and the Commonwealth Belt, currently property of Michael Jones, which is slipping away as Jamie Moore continues to pile on the sensible pressure, keeping the defence fairly tight and the angles difficult. He's come of age, hasn't he?
He has. He's learnt a lot from that defeat, obviously. Still only 24 years of age, maturing all the time, obviously getting naturally stronger all the time, and has put in the performance of his career so far tonight.
Steve Foster and Steve Wood, who co-managed Jamie Moore, have always thought he would come good. They never had any doubts. Boxing's a funny game, and you've got to take your chances. Jamie was saying this week that he couldn't just not take this. He may never get it again. And he has taken it with both hands.
Poke it out, Mick. Poke it out, Mick. Don't wait.
Body shot from Jones. Tries vainly to stop the Moore charge. But he just keeps coming forward, doesn't he?
Jones has got nothing. He can throw it more. Moore just marching forward, walking through everything Jones has got.
We wondered the other week when Hatton fought Vince Phillips whether there was a chance that Phillips could find a right hand, because he had that power. There was always a hope. But when Scott Harrison fought Wayne McCulloch didn't have that equaliser. And you wonder whether Michael Jones has that turnaround punch. Is it just a question of Jamie Moore staying on his feet, and he's going to become a double champion?
Surely Jamie Moore's got to be miles in front. But he's not. not going to take his foot off the gas. He's going to keep going here, Jamie Moore. He's putting in the performance of his life.
Valiant response from Jones again. The gum shield comes out. The nose has caused him so much trouble since it was split open in the early stages. John Coyle still hasn't noticed and nearly tripped over his own gum shield there, Michael Jones. Standing on it. John Coyle's seen it. What's he going to do this time? Back it goes to the corner. Again, we have another break. And again, no point deducted.
Well, I'm amazed that referee John Coyle surely should have taken the point off by now. But again, another round for Moore. Surely all he's got to do is stay on his feet for these next 6 minutes to become the new British Commonwealth champion.
Let's have a look at the punches landed. Well, almost double from Jamie Moore. Surprising, not as many body shots as we've seen before from him, but he totals nearly 200. And while Michael Jones has been brave, Jamie Moore was brave for even taking this fight, and his class showing.
Yeah, it certainly is. Jamie Moore's obviously done his homework. He's very confident in his ability. That's why he's taken the fight. And he's pulled the best
okay,
out of
him. Come on, bottle time now. Right, he's tired. Okay, he's tired. Right, put your shots. Box, bang, 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 and move.
When he comes, man, when he comes, come on.
Bottle time now, they're saying. It's a last gasp effort, this. 6 minutes to save his Commonwealth belt. And try and stop Jamie Moore from becoming the British light middleweight champion as well. Spencer has the difference of 8 points. It's John Coyle, the referee, who will decide. And there's a timeout here. Just a bit of tape loose on the left glove of Jamie Moore. And John Coyle, very experienced referee, surely seeing it the same way as you are. Jones needs a knockout.
He certainly does. I think a blind man can see that Jamie Moore's well ahead in this contest.
And Jones's manager, Jack Trickett, just went over to the corner there. Very, very worried about his charge. Oh. That's a good right uppercut, though, from the Liverpool fighter. And that was the best shot of the contest from him. And Moore sucked it up, but did it hurt him?
Didn't seem to hurt him that much. He seemed to take it quite well, but a beautiful right uppercut pick there.
So you wonder, preparing for the tall, rangy Paul Samuels, maybe he didn't work on uppercuts too much. How is it with the shorter guy? Should he have used that shot more? He does again.
It was certainly working for him in there now.
Trying to rally both fighters who have given us a tremendous, courageous clash here in Liverpool tonight. Both can be very proud of their achievements, but it's Jamie Moore who stands, we would think, on the threshold, unless Michael Jones can turn the script upside down. Gum shield out again. He doesn't mind. He wins in body. to win the round. He needs more than that, surely.
He certainly does. There we see the beautiful shot from Jones. Picked it lovely. Neglected the shot all night. A little short right uppercut. Perfect shot for Jamie Moore. He's only found the shot now in the 11th round. Could it be too late? Some of the other good work from Jamie Moore in the round.
Look at that. Tells the story. Can Jamie Moore hang on? These two may be leagues apart from the king of the world, Oscar De La Hoya, who runs the light middleweight division at the moment. But they've given us a cracker at domestic level here at the Everton Park Sports Centre tonight. Under 3 minutes for Michael Jones to stop Jamie Moore, and surely that's what he's got to do. Or will it be the sweetest night of the Salford Southpaws' four-year professional career?
Well, if I was a gambling man, I think you'd certainly have to put your money on Jamie Moore here. He's looked confident from the opening bell. He's the one that's looked like the champion. Jones is the one that's looked ruffled right from the first bell. Mature performance from Jamie Moore. He obviously learnt a lot in defeat.
Again, he catches him with a jab and a left hook. He's looked so cool, Jamie Moore, for his first championship fight. Just looks down at his corner. Gum shield again. That's been a nightmare for Michael Jones. Never really recovered from the nose that's been bleeding profusely all the way through the championship contest. Never settled, never got into range or his rhythm. It has been Jamie Moore that has controlled the centre of the ring and the pace from round one.
Yeah, in total control, Jamie Moore landing pretty much at will now. Michael Jones's face is looking a complete mess.
Southpaw, who managed to get inside and work his fight.
fight.
Well, let's take into consideration that the fight was changed at short notice. Jamie Moore originally was meant to be boxing Paul Samuels, a totally different style of fighter. And there's my scorecard, 119-109, really dominated for me, Jamie Moore.
Dreams come true. Paul Michael Jones, the destiny will have to wait. The destiny for Jamie Moore is at 24. He is a double champion at light middleweight. And, well, it's fairy tale stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 fantastic rounds of boxing, referee John Coyle has scored this contest for Jones 111, for Moore 118. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, the winner and the new British and Commonwealth light middleweight champion from Salford, Jamie Moore.
Well, John Coyle had it almost exactly as Spencer Oliver did. A wide points margin. And Jamie Moore has the night of his life. Look at what those belts mean to him.
And surely the biggest surprise of all is the manner of the victory. A marvellous night for Moore. Plenty more good action to come from Liverpool. And just a reminder that Floyd Mayweather is live later. Our top of the bill tonight from Fresno in California. A tough-looking defence of the WBC World Lightweight title for Mayweather against Victoriano Sosa of the Dominican Republic. What a performance from Moore, Barry. Did you ever think that that kind of effort was in him on his career so far?
I didn't think that he had enough time to get ready for the fight. He proved me wrong, and I'll tell you what's more, his defence has improved remarkably. He paced himself very well, and his performance all round is very special. He held it together when he hurt Jones, and just gradually increased the pressure, took him apart, won it by a landslide.
We didn't know about his ability, Barry, but if you look back in the record, you know, last fight, he was right on the 11-stone limit. Mm. So therefore, he didn't have that to worry about in terms of fitness. He's a young professional, isn't he?
He filled up into the weight division. He's a big guy. I always thought he was too big for welterweight anyway. And he's now a very solid light middleweight. And a really interesting contribution to a very hot division.
He's worked so hard to have both of those belts draped around him. Good luck to him. Ed Roberts is going to speak to him now.
Well, Jamie, at late notice and against all odds, that was a stunning performance to capture the British and Commonwealth titles.
Yeah, thanks a lot. I trained hard anyway. Had an absolutely crap performance last time, which was live on Sky. Got slated a bit for it. But he was down to not doing the weight properly, and I've had some expert advice since then, and everything worked brilliant tonight. Just couldn't turn the opportunity down because of how I felt, and it's paid off over the moon.
You managed to outbox someone we thought was the master boxer.
Yeah, well, everyone always thought was a fighter. I think I shown after the Dixon fight that I started to box more through Oliver getting me boxing more, and I could always box. He come off tonight though, brilliant.
Gutsy effort from Jones, but was it actually easier than you expected?
No, not at all. To be honest with you, I didn't think he'd be able to take the pressure, but what a tough, strong boy he is, and all the respect in the world to him.
You seem to have learned from the Scott Dixon defeat. At 24, the future is suddenly very exciting.
Yeah, well, that is the best lesson I've ever had in boxing, from being amateur and professional. And, I mean, a lot of the credit for my boxing goes to me old amateur trainer from years back. If it weren't for him, I wouldn't be where I am today, and a lot of thanks to him. And I'm just over the moon, everything comes right tonight.
And take the two belts back to Salford.
The first person from Salford to win a British title in over 100 years. So I'm absolutely ecstatic. I've got a Tenerife now. Can't wait.
Well done tonight.
Thanks very much.
Isn't that fantastic? Underlining all that it means to him. We wish him well from here. Barry, Jim and Nicky review the best of the action. More on Floyd Mayweather. And when we come back, another Liverpool favourite, Tony Dodson, in action at super middleweight against Pierre Moreno. And well done to Jamie Moore, the new British and Commonwealth light middleweight champion. Steve Foster, his co-manager, is thrilled with him, and why not? Jim, was it about attitude? Was that the determinant factor in that fight for you?
Yeah, it just would not be denied from the first bell. I mean, I've never questioned his talents. My doubts were always in his stamina, and he certainly put those doubts well to rest tonight. That was a tremendous pace for the 12 rounds. But Jones's main asset was always his jab. And by the second round, I think Moore had solved that out and taken it away from him. And from that point on, he really dominated the fight.
I know they hadn't had long to prepare a game plan, but the way Moore set about the task, setting a brisk early pace, they'd done their homework, hadn't they?
Yeah, well, they knew they had to get close. They couldn't stand off with this fellow. I thought he'd have a lot of trouble getting close. In the first round, possibly he did. But from that point on, he seemed to have the job solved. They just set about doing that. Full credit to Jones for the part he played in tonight. That was the knockdown there. It was a flash knockdown, I think partly balanced. A definite knockdown, but a flash knockdown because Jones took far better punches as the fight went on and stayed on his feet. But only one winner. And by this stage, the fourth round, you could see the likelihood of Jones getting himself back into the fight was becoming more and more remote.
He paid such a heavy penalty for being a slow starter tonight, didn't he, Michael Jones?
Well, he did, but more, I think, although you say he set a brisk pace for him, it was actually quite a controlled, conservative
pace. He thought the job through.
Exactly. He paced himself at 12 rounds, and that's why he lasted so well. We know he's fit, and Jones fought back as a champion is supposed to do, and had a few brief moments of success, but Moore really took everything away. He out-jabbed him, which was a surprise. Moore's actually got quite a long reach for somebody who was only 5'8", so that was to his advantage. But Jones couldn't handle the southpaw stance and the boxing ability of Moore.
I think it was Jones's inability to hit him with the jab. He could not penetrate his defence. That's what I was most impressed with tonight with Moore. He kept a very tight defence. It was very hard to hit with the jab. And once Jones was unable to hit him with the jab, the fight started slipping away from him right from the very beginning.
And Barry, was that mainly because he just did not deal with the fact he was fighting a southpaw here?
Well, I think he tried to dominate the fight from the centre of the ring. He normally tries to get off first and beat his opponent to the punch and use his ranginess. But he was unable to nail him with the jab, which meant Moore was able to slip inside it and catch him with his own counter punches. And really, once he started to hurt him, he hasn't got the strong, robust body to be able to absorb the sort of punishment he was taking early on, and therefore the fight just slipped away from him.
He's lapping it up in his dressing room, isn't he? Quite rightly so. And Nicky, it doesn't underline, you know, there's a lot of bogus titles out there, but these old titles, traditional titles, they are what really matter to the young fighters in the game in this country.
Exactly.
He's thrilled with himself.
These titles will be here in 100 years' time, and lots of these WB whatevers will be gone in a few years' time, and their tradition, and they've got history, and they mean something to these guys.
Fantastic effort tonight. Really enjoyed that from Jamie Moore. Let's hope we see more of him, and let's hope that Michael Jones can regroup after what will be a crushing defeat for him.
For all boxing info, news, and latest interviews, amateur and pro, across and off, click and subscribe. VIP Boxing Promotions. Also, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.